Hi y'all, I'm here in PD today, hoping to do a quick demonstration of aliasing. Don't worry if you don't know anything about pure data, I've got a very simple patch here, and I'll talk you through everything that's in it. I talked about aliasing in my video about sample rate, but thinking about it, I didn't really give a very good explanation or demonstration of it. So here, aliasing is unwanted frequencies that are produced when a sound is sampled at less than twice the highest frequency component of that sound. So, for example, let's look at this picture. We have this red waveform that we're sampling. We're going to convert this red waveform into digital. But since our sampling rate is slower than twice the frequency, when we convert into digital, what's actually going to be recorded is this blue waveform, this waveform that doesn't exist, but has been created by sampling at less than that Nyquist rate. Now, this can be hard to demonstrate with an audio interface, because your audio interface has that anti-aliasing filter in it to prevent aliasing from happening. But working in pure data, I can create these aliasing frequencies. So what I have in my patch here is just an oscillator here, a sine wave oscillator that goes to an audio out. This multiply tilde 0.3 is just to make it a little bit quieter so we don't blow our ears out. And then I have a number here that lets me control my frequency. My oscillator, before I attenuate it, is also sending to the oscilloscope perceived here. And now this is just something that's going to let me visualize the sound a little bit. This is a pretty cheap oscilloscope, but it'll be fine for our purposes today, and I didn't want to build something too distracting from what we're focused on. I'm going to go to my PD window and start my sound. So here we are. We have an oscillator, a sine wave oscillator, going at 200 hertz. 500 hertz, 1,000 hertz, 5,000 hertz, and we can keep going up. 10,000, 15, 20. Again, not sure if 20,000 will make it into the encoding of this video. That's not the point. So, if I go here, let me stop this for a second, just in case it is going. Just turn the DSP off there. Let me pull up my audio options here. Audio preferences. So the sample rate right now is 44,100, which means our Nyquist frequency is going to be 22,050. Again, Nyquist frequency is half the sample rate. So let's see what happens when I go beyond 20,000. Let's go to 30,000. 40,000. So what frequency is that? That's an aliasing frequency, of course. And the way we can work out what frequency the new alias frequency is at is we can take the sample rate, which we know is 44,100, and subtract the original frequency. So 44,100 minus 40,000 is going to be 4,100. Well, let's check. So let's set our frequency to be 4,100. Hey, that's the same. Back up to 40,000. I'm going to raise this up. Here, as I increase the number, the aliased frequency is going to keep getting lower. Because again, it's the sample rate minus the original frequency. So if we want to get 100 hertz, we could put in 44,000. Okay, now let's go to our audio options and we can change the sample rate. We can change it to 48,000, okay? So now, at 44,000, with a sample rate of 48,000, we should be aliasing at 4,000 hertz. Hey, we got it. Again, going up. 48,000 minus 44,407, 44,407. 3,393? Oh, I did my math wrong. I can't go back and figure it out because I can't remember what that number was. I'll put a comment or something. Okay. Audio preferences. Let's set our sample rate to be 16,000 hertz. So in theory, we're going to start aliasing now above 8,000 hertz, right? Let's start at 7,000. So now above 8,000 hertz. Because again, our sample rate is now 16,000 hertz minus, well, let me get a nice round number. Let's set it to just, okay. Sample rate, 16,000 hertz minus 10,000 hertz. We should be aliasing now at 6,000 hertz. Okay, so this is a neat little demo with sine waves, but let's think about this now if we're trying to record music. If we're trying to record music and the different frequencies and harmonics are aliasing, we're gonna get a mess really fast. So while this is fun to play within our little audio experiment, this is certainly something we do not want to be happening in our digital recordings. So again, demonstrating the importance of our anti-aliasing filter.